What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Hit the Movies Revealed channel here on YouTube. As you know, we do podcasts. We talk about movies. And with movies, we talk about physical media. And I myself own a couple of steelbooks, Blu-rays, 4K, box sets, so on and so forth. I'm also a huge fan of, right here, the Criterion Collection. As you can see, I'm going to go ahead and kind of focus here. If you don't know what the Criterion Collection is, I encourage you to look it up. The Criterion Collection has an incredible set of just incredible movies spanning all of film history. I myself have a small collection right here, as you can see in the back. I got Uncut Gems, which I'm going to talk about a little bit because this is specifically in 4K. And then Bill Durham and the following, Christopher Nolan's first film. What's special about this one today, as you can tell from the title of the video, is this is the 4K release of Raging Bull. I am a huge fan of 4K. Those are some of the movies that I have down there that are in 4K that I purchased again from, you know, having the Blu-ray previously. And so as soon as I heard this one was going to be in 4K, I knew I had to grab it. I knew it had to be added to the Criterion Collection. And I'll also say this, 4K looks fantastic. The transfer looks incredible when the movie was filmed in that film format instead of digital. And I'm sure the black and white is just going to pop, and it's already a great looking picture. And so I can't even imagine what they did on this one. But without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at it. Obviously, it's still in the shrink wrap down here below. It is director approved. Martin Scorsese approved this release of the film, which is pretty notable. I mean, we always got to, you know, we got to give kudos to that. 4K Ultra HD comes with the Blu-ray. Raging Bull, Robert De Niro on the front right there. On the side here, it says a Martin Scorsese picture, Robert De Niro at the top. On the side here, you have your typical Criterion Collection tag, 1980. You flip it on the side right here, basic spine. And on the back, it will show all the special features. We'll definitely get a closer look, obviously, when we open it up, because now you can see the glare. You can kind of see me in the background there. But all the different features that it has right there, even right there specifically, 1980, 129 minutes, black and white color, 2.0 surround sound, and a 1.85:1 aspect ratio. But without further ado, let's go ahead and pop this open. I'm super excited to see what it is. Just off the bat here, though, as I'm opening this, I'm a little bit disappointed. This is your stereotypical Criterion Collection cover, but I'm a little bit disappointed that they didn't do something a little bit more special for the release of Raging Bull. And I'm talking about like maybe a slip cover, a design cover, something like that. As you can see from the back right there, Uncut Gems had a spectacular case. It comes out and had great artwork inside. And so that's a nitpick. I'm going to be honest. That's a nitpick. But I think this movie would have been awesome if it had like a little slip cover. But it is a little bit weighted. So I'm excited to see what is inside of this, because this is fairly heavy. So some kind of booklet in here that is pretty heavy. Let's go ahead and pop it open. And right off the bat, that is really cool. For the Ultra HD 4K disc, it's in red. Obviously, you have the C around there. And then, so let's pop that out for just a moment. I'm going to set that off to the side here. And then inside, you have the Blu-ray disc, which is a, you know, basic Criterion Collection design. We're going to go ahead and pop that one out as well. Got to definitely be careful with that. And then you have Robert De Niro, his character inside. That is pretty cool. Always love some good artwork inside. And like I said, heavy booklet right here. And that's actually going to be the only thing. And then that's the full image that you get inside the disc or inside the case. So that's going to go set on top here. And then let's go ahead and just take a gander of what's going on inside here. Great black and white photography. I mean, it's the only photography, right? There's no color in this film. And so flip it open, got your table of contents, some great images. Look at that. Behind the scene photos of Martin Scorsese and Robert De Niro. Look at that. The man in action directing one of the, arguably one of the greatest movies to come out. Inside, you got your little casting credits. More photos. Robert De Niro, Joe Pesci. I believe that's Joe Pesci. Is that Joe Pesci? And then a little film essay inside. I'll definitely be diving into that. Fairly long here. Some more photos in here. Film essay still going on, still going on. Great behind the scene photo right there. Behind the scene photos right there. Beginning of the film. Awesome. Just awesome. And then we got Never Got Me Down by Glenn Kenny. Looks like another film essay of some kind taking place. So two film essays inside. Some more photos, black and white photos from production. These look like part of behind the scenes still photos. And some more photos there, behind the scene photos. A little bit of camera action right there. All of them in the boxing corner. About the master, acknowledgement, special thanks. And that is the end of the booklet. Oops, kind of bent it a little bit. I don't know if I did that or if it came like that. But that's about it. Let's put that sucker back in, and then we'll pop the disc back in. But go ahead and comment down below what you think about this release for the Criterion Collection. I'm sure the quality, the picture quality of the film is going to look incredible. I cannot wait to pop it in. Huge fan of black and white photo, black and white films already. And so to see this in 4K at its best should be spectacular. A little bit disappointed in, you know, kind of just hoping that there would have been a little bit more design. Like I said, with other 4K releases, they kind of been doing that. Uncut Gems, for example. I mean, they just went all out. And so I was kind of hoping for the same thing for Raging Bull, but not the case. And that's okay, because all that matters is the picture quality in the movie. But go ahead, today is release day. If you picked it up, go ahead and let me know down below. And let me know what you think. And where would you rank Raging Bull as one of the best films of all time? Interested to know? Go ahead and comment down below. Be sure to like and subscribe for more movie content. And I will see you guys next time.